Hey guys, what is up and welcome back to the channel. Today, we are going to be taking a look at some pretty insane performance and graphical improvements to RPCS3. Specifically, we're going to be taking a look at some brand new patches that drastically improve the visual quality and performance of God of War 3 and also Killzone 3. These patches were made by Illusion and WhatCookie. These guys are members of the modding and development community over in RPCS3's Discord server, and if you've watched videos of mine covering this emulator in the past, you likely already know these guys' names, since they in fact worked on many of the patches that this emulator utilizes, including the patches that dramatically improve the performance and playability of The Last of Us. These new patches disable the usage of SPU MLAA and MLAA in Killzone 3 and God of War 3. This not only greatly improves performance, but also for these two titles enables you to scale their resolution. Let's take a quick example of Killzone 3 running at its native resolution at 720p versus scaled up to 2560 by 1440. As we transition from 720 to 1440p, you'll also notice that our performance has sizably improved thanks to the removal of MLAA with this patch. We are now not only able to play it at much higher frame rates, but also at much higher scaled resolutions. To show you just how much performance has increased thanks to the disabling of this MLAA, we're going to take a quick snippet of gameplay from the very starting section of Killzone 3. On the left, we have the game natively running at 720p and without the patch, and on the right, we have MLAA disabled, the game running at 1440p. As you can see by the performance numbers in the top of the window, the game runs at sometimes 2 times the performance level that it previously did. Now, something that should be noted is that if you're playing Killzone 3 with this new MLAA disable patch, you can and should disable right color buffers. It greatly improves performance. Please remember to disable it. It can be found in the GPU tab within the emulator's custom configuration window. While this MLAA patch does make Killzone 3 infinitely more usable, due to, I believe, texture upload issues in specific areas of game, there are still a lot of performance issues with this title, so for that reason, it cannot be called playable. As I said at the beginning of this video, God of War 3 has also seen some patching love. This comes in the form of an MLAA removal patch, which was made by WhatCookie, then a separate SPU MLAA disabling patch, which was created by Illusion. As with Killzone 3, this game is also greatly improved in performance with the utilization of these two patches, and as with the previous game, these patches also allow God of War 3 to scale its resolution for the first time higher than 720p on this emulator. The gameplay footage you're currently watching is of God of War 3 running at my preferred resolution, 1440p, but man, does this game look crisp at this higher resolution. It's hard to believe that a game that was released 10 years ago can look this good when scaled in resolution. Hopefully, with further fixes to this game's stability and performance, it'll become yet another awesome playable game added to this PlayStation 3 emulator's library. In the next few days, I'm going to be covering at length RPCS3's latest changes. Since I now have an actual functional computer with which I can make videos, test emulators, and get them released, you can expect a lot more videos in the coming month from me. So make sure to hit the subscribe button and bell icon to get notified as soon as those videos are uploaded. For anybody looking for a pre-made patch containing all of these new patch changes for Killzone, God of War, and many other games, you'll find a pre-made one down in the description of this video and a direct link to the patch repository if you want to see if any new patches have been added since last you checked. And for anybody wondering what settings I'm using for these games, I'm just going to quickly flash them on screen before I leave you with some extended gameplay footage of God of War 3 running using this brand new performance and rendering patch. Once again, guys, thank you all very, very much for checking out this video. I greatly appreciate your viewership. I also want to give a huge, huge thank you to all of my Patreon supporters. You guys have been a massive, massive help, not only with supporting my channel, but also just in general help in both my Discord server and here on YouTube. So again, a massive thank you to each and every one of you. Once again, guys, thank you all very much for checking out this video. Remember to like it if you liked it, dislike it if you didn't, and subscribe to the channel if you want to see all future videos from me. You